Right, guys, we're here with Rob Marsh, prolific catcher of carp. He's a jack of all trades when it comes to carp fishing, but we're just going to try and sort of concentrate on what Rob would do in a situation where you're fishing over gravel. So over to you, Rob. Just let us know, you know, what the ins and outs are, what you've done, you know, just your general approach to gravel fishing.
Well, number one point is for me hook, I prefer an in-turn point. It can get caught on the gravel and it can burr the point over, so I prefer a hook with an in-turn point. It just protects the hook a little bit and doesn't get damaged so easily. I prefer a braided hook link. At the moment I've been fishing a very weedy lake, but it's got some gravel areas, and I want to fish the drop-off system so I can fish it safely. And the only way I've found really to do this, I can't use lead core, so I've been using straight on with the nylon. So I've come up with this rig to basically allow me to fish solid bags on the gravel, and you get a better presentation.
Well, I mean, your lead looks like it's a lump of gravel anyway, doesn't it? It's quite a heavy lead.
It's a heavy lead because there's a lot of weed in the lake. I want to make sure I lose the lead. And obviously I can use a lead core rig and you fish on the outside, but I've had problems because I can't use lead core in the water that I'm fishing at the moment. It stopped me from actually fishing on the outside of the lead, and because I'm using gravelly leads to match the bottom, I've had to come up with this little rig to make sure that I can drop the lead on a take, but also not damage the line as it goes around the outside of the lead.
Yeah.
So what I've actually done is I've used some shrink tube and actually run that round the lead. And this allows me then, on the drop-off system, and literally these two little soft silicon will pull off really easy. So on a take, literally it's just a case of that. And then once this main line's being pulled, that lead is hanging, and that, once it's wet, will just drop off really easily. And then that's allowing then to me to lose the lead, and then the fish is in the upper layers and you can fight the fish and you're not getting the lead masting the weed and carrying the weed, and not only that, stopping you from landing the fish.
Are you finding the fish when you hook them, and are they sort of hitting the surface?
Yes.
Quite a lot of the
time? Yeah, a lot of the times. As soon as that lead's off, it's a total different battle.
Yeah.
And me and Lee used this sort of drop-off lead system. Obviously with lead core on waters where we can, for our match fishing, especially for smaller fish as well, they're head shakers.
Yeah.
If you can drop that lead, you will land 9 out of 10 fish.
Yeah, it's a lot.
It's that lead swinging around, because that's the sort of action you've got from the fish's mouth to the line. You always think that it's dead straight. It's never dead straight because of the stretch in the line and everything else. That's hanging like that, and that fish is pulling on that rig, on the fish all the time. If you can get rid of that lead, that is a direct line to the fish.
So you've got direct contact all the time while you're playing the fish.
Yeah.
I mean, I notice you've got a lot of things pinning everything down. You know?
Well, obviously it's in a bag, so you don't want it to loop up once the bag dissolves and all your little. I like lots of little chops and a bit of pellet and lots of bits and pieces in there. And if it comes up and it just, once the bait's sort of been spread out, once the fish are sucking around, and you end up with a bit of the line popped up like that, it's no good. So I just like to pin it all down so it's all there, even though it's all scrunched up in a bag. It's not even when the fish are disturbed, it's not going to pop up.
So you'd always fish that sort of setup in a PVA bag?
On gravel, I prefer to.
And this is just tungsten putty?
Just tungsten putty, yeah. Just pinched on the line, just enough. And size 7 claw hook.
Well, it's quite interesting because what you've got here is you're fishing a bag, and a lot of people would fish half the length.
Yeah.
I'm very similar. I always use it, even in a bag. I like to have a little bit of travel on the hook link.
I always get asked this question, why do you have such long hook links in a bag? And my theory is not all fish are feeding hard on that gravel.
Yeah.
And if they're feeding hard on the gravel when you've got a hook link that's 3 inches long, that's fine, you're still going to hook the fish. If that fish is off that bottom and he's feeding from 6 inches a foot away and sucking everything up from there, which they do, we've seen them do it, a 3-inch hook link is only going to get to there and stop and not go in the back of his mouth. So I still use a long hook link, even though it's all scrunched up. If the fish is sucking from a distance, that will reach its mouth and still get me that hook hold that I need, and then drop that lead.
Yep.
Again, in the bag, to throw the fish, chop the boilie up, make it all small, make it irregular.
Well, looks like a tiger nut, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just a little chop boilie, little bit of colour for sight, and literally everything, keep everything all different shapes and sizes in the bag. You don't need to use a big boilie, just chop it all down, and they're picking up all them little bits and pieces, and rather than steering away from a boilie, they think it's just another little food item.
Mm.
And it just allows me to fish in on the gravel, but there's also a lot of weed present, so I know that I'm safely going to get the fish in and drop the lead.
Drop the lead off, yeah.
So like I say, it just pops off like that. and then the lead drops.
Like you say, if it was in water, it would come off a lot easier.
I've tested it, and every fish this trip, every fish, even the bream, I'm not getting a lead back.
Right.
It's losing the lead every time. It's just a couple of silicons holding that. But that's the little key, is if you can put that little bit of shrink tube on to protect your line around the lead. Look, smooth leads are fine. If you've got a smooth lead, that's fine. You don't need to do that, which I fished when I'm fishing zigs. Fish it outside the lead on a smooth lead. But if you want to sort of get a lead that sort of suits the bottom, like them gravel ones there, if you just put a little bit of shrink tube on there, it doesn't take long. Shrink it down.
It's quite interesting what you just said on zigs. So you use the same drop-off on zigs as well?
That is the massive thing with zigs. Zig fishing is another prime example. You've got such a long length of line between there and the lead. As you're playing that fish, whatever level that fish is fighting in, that lead is dragging on the bottom. It's never straight line like that, it's dragging, and that fish can come off. You see so many people lose fish on zigs. The most important is you've got to lose that on the take. If you lose the lead on the take, you'll land the fish. When we're doing these matches and we're big hit fishing, if you can get rid of the lead, I know it's expensive, but then if you're getting them fishing every time,
it's worth it. It's worth every time, you know.
You've got to lose the lead. It's one of the most important, I think, one of the most important parts of carp fishing.
Well, thanks, Rob, for your insight. That's an insight into Rob's gravel fishing, and he's got some good ideas there. And I think I might be using something like that myself. I love that drop-off lead system. That's brilliant. Mm. Very, very clever. Thanks, Rob.
Cheers.
Cheers.